Apple's new iPad-specific OS, or iPadOS, is coming this fall, and it's bringing a bunch of new features that make it more like a computer than ever before. In this video is a full guide on how to use the new Split-View and Multitasking features, so let's get started. Multitasking starts with the app dock, so let's fill it up with the apps we use every day. Something new this year is the ability to put entire app folders onto the dock, so you can have access to any app you want from just the dock. Starting with slide-over mode, first open an app, then swipe up from the bottom to bring up the dock, then drag an app onto the side of the screen, but don't drag it to the very edge. You can now use both apps at the same time, or drag items from one app into the other, like images, links, or files. You can also swipe the bar on the bottom of the slide-over window to switch between other apps you have open in slide-over mode. Or you can swipe up on that bar to show all of the apps at once and choose which one you'd like to use. You can also drag the top of the slide-over window to the other side of the screen. Slide-over mode is very useful for doing things like quickly bringing up the Files app and dragging files into apps like Luma Fusion for video editing. If you don't have the desired app open in one of your slide-over windows, just drag the app from the dock and it'll replace the current app. Once you're finished, just grab the edge of the window and swipe it off the screen, and you can swipe again to bring it back. To switch to split view mode, just pull the top bar down and into the edge of the screen. At that point, you can bring back the slide-over window by swiping from the edge, and you can move it to the other side, just as before. And pulling down on the slide-over app's top bar will replace the underlying split-view app. You can easily swap the positions of the apps by dragging the top bar of an app to the other side. You can also drag the bar in the center of the apps to give more space to either app, either in a 50-50 or 25-75 split. To replace an app while in split view, just drag it from the app dock. You can even use the same app on both sides of the screen, which is useful for transferring files in the Files app, and it should work for third-party apps like Microsoft Word, but it doesn't seem to be working yet in this first beta of iPadOS. Within the Notes app, you can even grab a note and drag it to the side of the screen to open both notes side by side. While the Mail app is open, you can compose a new email and drag the Compose view to the side in either slide over or split view mode. Hit cancel or send and it'll automatically close. The coolest part is that you can swipe along the bottom of the screen to swipe between apps, and all the different split view app combinations you previously had open will be saved, including as many versions of each app as you'd like. You can also swipe with four fingers instead to switch between apps, or swipe up to get to the home screen, or swipe up and stop at the center to open the app switcher and choose the app you want to use. If you want to exit split view mode, just pull down on one of the app's tabs to get into slide over mode, then swipe it off the screen. Now let's say you're at the home screen and you want to start a fresh version of an app, but it keeps opening up the same app that's already in split view. Well, simply tap and hold on an app in the dock or on the home screen, and tap Show All Windows to open the app expose. From here, you'll see the various versions of the app currently open, and you can swipe to close them, or tap the plus icon to start fresh. If you want to get back to a different version of the app you're currently using, just tap the same app within the app dock and it'll open up that same app expose. Now in Safari, we finally get automatic desktop mode for browsing. Into split view, just tap and hold on a tab and drag it to the edge of the screen. You can also watch videos in picture-in-picture mode if the video player supports it by tapping the PIP button. You can now swipe between apps and use your iPad while the video plays. You can tap to pause, close, or bring it back to the Safari window. You can also drag it to any corner of the screen and spread it with two fingers to make the video larger. You can use PIP on YouTube, but it'll only play while the tab is open and you can't move it around. But it's useful if you want to browse YouTube. Apple's also adding some text editing features that can really speed up your workflow. You can quickly pick up your cursor with one finger and move it around anywhere you'd like, or use two fingers anywhere on the screen. You can also tap multiple times to select different amounts of text. Tap twice to select a word, tap three times, or for some reason four times in this beta version, to select a sentence, and tap four times, or for us, five times, to select an entire paragraph. You can then pinch with three fingers to copy, and then spread with three fingers to paste. To undo, you don't have to shake it anymore. Just swipe left with three fingers, and then swipe right with three fingers to redo. And finally, you can pinch with two fingers on the keyboard to shrink it, and then grab the tab to move it wherever you'd like on the screen, allowing you to type with just one thumb or finger, or use the new swipe keyboard feature. Then you can pinch with two fingers again to bring it back to the full keyboard. So that was everything you need to know about multitasking in Apple's new iPadOS. If this video helped you out, make sure to tap that like button and click the circle above to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.